Chopper down, you are cleared for approach.
Jericho Stewart. He's in and out of prison more than half his life. He's got no impulse control. He's unable to calculate the consequences of his actions. He has a total lack of empathy for anybody or anything. He feels nothing.
You know who I am?
My head.
Your name is Bill Pope. You're an intelligence officer for the CIA. Your daughter's name? Emma. Your wife, Jill, huh?
What did you do to me?
Hey, look at me. Pay attention. Jan Struve, Dutch program. He needed protection, remember? You got him to the safe house. Where did you put him? That is all we need to know. I need you to remember.
I don't remember nothing. You don't know me, but I know you.
Who are you?
First question, what page were you on in the script when you knew, I gotta play Jericho, this is for me?
Well, I have to be honest, at first, you know, the producers and directors saw me in draft day.
Okay.
And thought I could play this criminal, which really baffled me when I read it. But I remember thinking when he was in prison, and they shoot him with one dart, and he goes, you know, it's gonna take two.
Love that.
And I thought that was it started to tell me about him, that even under those weird conditions, that he found a way to play.
Mm.
You know, he would eat his hot dog in peace until, he wasn't impressed with those men that walked in. There's nothing about them that scared him at all. So that line rang really true to me. It's gonna take two. And as I kept going through, you know, his sense of wonder and his sense of spontaneous survival and his resourcefulness in difficult situations, who was at play? Was it the criminal? And sometimes when he had to mix some bottles of chemicals, that was really Ryan Reynolds, because he would have no concept of that. And so trying to figure that out was part of a bit of a puzzle for me.
There's a shift there seems to be against a hero and now the anti-hero. And Jericho seems to be somewhat of an anti-hero. What do you think that says about us culturally and where we're going in this show?
I don't think there's ever been a shift for me. I've always responded to Cool Hand Luke, to Sand Pebbles. I've played, I think, anti-heroes, you know, a lot in my career. From No Way Out to, you know, to Bull Durham, to these people that aren't supposed, don't look like they're going to win and don't effectively, but you root for them, you know, a perfect world, you know, and things like that. So those anti-heroes never fallen out of style for me. So I don't know if there's been a shift. I mean, I see so many kind of giant comic movies, so I'm not sure we're shifting to anti-hero at all. But I think, all they are is they're conflicted people. They're actually just a little more authentic, generally speaking.
What are you doing in my basement? Did you work with Billy?
I don't think anyone like him ever would have worked with somebody like me. They stuck Billy in my head. I got a scar, see? All the stuff that he knew, all the stuff that he could do, I got it all scrambled up inside me.
It's impossible.
First car you two ever bought, used Rover. Bum clutch blew the first week. I told you, they stuck his brain in me.
That's enough. Just a second, baby.
Billy could never hurt you, Jill, so neither can I.
Now, styling-wise, Jericho has a couple of different looks. How did that help you navigate the character?
It helped me. That was the number one thing. When I flew on the plane, I didn't know how I was going to play him. And they didn't have a rehearsal period. I went over there with long hair and the long beard, thinking we're going to start in the prison. And the first scene was in, it was in Gall's bedroom where I attempt to assault her. Mm-hmm. So I couldn't do that with that look. And I had to go into the trailer, and the look I came up with my makeup and hair person was a look that carried us through the movie. And it was really kind of dicey because whatever we did was gonna, we were gonna live with. And so we kept trimming and then put those awful scars on, which I thought was very, very important sure. to the character to not get cosmetically caught up in trying to pretend, you know, wink, wink, I'm a criminal, but I don't look like one or I don't, whatever. You know, we did that. But flying over, I didn't know how I was gonna sound or exactly how I was gonna play it. I was prepared, I was off book, but I didn't have a clue. But when I walked out of that trailer and I remember having that thing on my neck, I knew that it would have affected my voice and I knew how to walk. So I found it, and it's not the way I like to work. I would prefer to go in knowing what I'm going to do. So I think we pulled it off, but I don't take the wrong lesson from that. I still want to be prepared when I go into my next movie.
Excellent, excellent. Thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome.